Hello subscribers and new viewers, this is Piyush Pant, I'm an architect and you are watching People's TV English. Subscribe our channel, like and share the videos and help us in spreading the free knowledge. It is free and always will be. So in this video, we will know how to get ultra high resolution maps and also with latest data showing in the map with the help of Google Earth and Global Mapper. Now let's start with opening Google Earth first. Type your site address in the search bar. For example, I am searching for Taj Mahal, Agra, India. Hit search button. And let's fly to our site, Taj Mahal. Let's bring the Taj Mahal campus boundary in front. Zoom it a bit so that the whole boundary of Taj Mahal campus is visible. Okay, so now let's go to the layer panel on left hand side. You will see so many layers are there which gives you various data about the site overlay on it. Like now, only borders and label layer is on, by which we can see the labels by their name and borders of the site. There is one layer called 3D buildings. When we on this layer, you will see a 3D build form will be overlaid on the build forms included in the site. Now let's off the 3D buildings layer and on the terrain layer. You will see the site will zoom automatically. It is actually showing the terrain of the site, or we can say elevation of the site from sea level. Now let's off the terrain layer and make our site flat and move forward to export the JPG or PNG image of the site directly. Remember, the Google Earth will export the whole image which is visible here in the window. So whichever site you want, you can zoom it to that level and export that area to get a clear picture. Now on the top, you will see a save image icon by which we can directly save the visible image. And if you are using older version, go to the file menu on the top, bring your mouse over save option and select save image from the list. You can also use Ctrl plus Alt plus S as keyboard shortcut to directly export the image. Now let's go back to save image icon and click it. You will see four icons will be displayed on all corners of the image. First one is where you can give title to the image. On the right hand top is legends panel. At right hand bottom will be the north tool or compass. On the bottom left is the Google trademark, and below the north tool we have a scale factor showing the scale of the image. When you bring your mouse over the title panel, it will show you a pencil icon. Click that, a title editing window dialog will open. Type the title here and close it. Rest all keep as it is. Now go to the map option rollout above, which will come only when you have used save image tool as we did earlier. Click that rollout, you will see that the list of elements which are visible on all four corners of the image, which we just saw, that is title, legends, compass, scale, etc. It gives you a control to keep or remove those elements by just unchecking the options and bring them back by checking them again. Keep all the elements checked and come to styling section. Here you can choose from the three options. First is full color. Second is medium color. And last is black and white image option. Let's keep it full colored for now. You can also save this configuration for future use and can load it anytime you want. Now let's come to the resolution rollout on the top. When we click it, you will see a list of options we get to save our image in different resolutions. We have current resolution, we have high definition, we have 4K ultra high definition and 8K ultra high definition or UHD also. To get 16K UHD image, we will use another software called Global Mapper after this. So let's select the maximum resolution available in the list. Now you will see all the icons on the corners have shrunk down and real resolution of the image is visible. Now hit the save image button at the top and define the file location. Name the file and hit save in the end. Now let's open the file which we just saved. You can see the whole image is saved which was visible in the Google Earth. When we zoom in, we can see the image is not pixelating or blurry. we are able to see all the elements in a clear manner. But one problem is there, this image is good of quality but is lacking the real-time effect. If you want to get latest images with latest data and development showing in the map, there is another way to find it. Let's open Google Earth again and go to the same address as before. Hit search button. Now here we will define the site boundary of our exact site we want by using the polygon tool at the top. A square cursor will come. Just create a boundary around your site by using the left mouse click. A white surface will be created indicating the selected boundary. Now on the polygon window dialog, rename the file and click OK. It will be saved in your places panel. Just stretch it a bit to get a full view. Here you can see it's already saved. Just use the right click and select save place as an option. Use the KMZ file type and save the file in desired location in your computer. Now let's open Global Mapper software. Click open data file option. Select the KMZ file which is saved from Google Earth and open it. You will see the site boundary will be reflecting in the working area. But it is just a rectangle, no image is there. So to get that image, go to Connect Online Data icon at the top. Or if you are using older version of Global Mapper, you can also go to File menu above and select Download Online Imagery. Let's click the icon. And remember, keep your internet connection on when you are doing this. An online data source window dialog will open, which has a list of many online geographical data sources. Many are free and some are premium as well. Now select worldwide data and click World Imagery from the list. Or you can go to Imagery Data Source and select World Imagery from there also. When it is selected, in the same dialog, you will find a draw box button. Click it. You will get another window dialog where you can select specific area of the site to be downloaded because the global mapper will import a large area than your boundary. So let's select the boundary area only and click OK. Now at the bottom in the dialog, you will find a detail level option. This option can enhance the level of detailing in your map image in many variables like colors, textures, and other elements. Let's slide the bar to maximum. Now click connect at the end. Based on your internet connection speed, Global Mapper will import the image. You can see our image has been downloaded. It has only the campus of our site which we need, not the whole area as it was in the Google Earth image. Now to export this image as JPG or PNG, in the left hand side in the control central panel, you will find two layers. One is boundary layer, which we got from Google Earth, and another is world imagery layer, which we downloaded here. Just select the world imagery layer, right click from your mouse, move your mouse to layer option, and select export option from the list. A select layer dialog will open, asking you to select or deselect different layers. So we don't want boundary layers. We just want the world imagery layer. So I will check only that box and click OK. An export format dialog will open, giving you a list of formats in which you can export your image like JPG, PDF and PNG also. For now, I will select GOTIFF format as it can also be opened as JPG or PNG. And is more better than that. Click OK to move ahead. Just click OK here as well. Now another dialog will open giving you more options for exporting your image. Like you can increase the bitrate to 24 with RGB color to create a large and good quality files. There are many other options which you can edit. For now just keep all as default and click OK. Name the file and hit save in the end. It will take little bit time depending on your computer performance and the size of the image. Now our writing is done and file is saved in our computer. Now let's open both the images we got from Google Earth and Global Mapper simultaneously and compare. On your left is the image from Global Mapper we just got and on your right is the image from Google Earth. When we zoom in Google Earth image, we can see the colors of various elements are not as real as we can see in our global mapper image. The Google Earth image looks more washed out in comparison to the left one. And also, I exported the image from the global mapper in January 2020, which is the winter season in that area and with lots of fog. That's why we can see a little bit of haziness here in left side image. And the Google Earth image is also exported on the same day, but the picture is old. When we compare the development of both the images, we can see the vegetation has grown more in the left hand side image. We can also see some of the people walking in the campus here in left hand side image. So, both images are good, but the image from Global Mapper has the upper hand if you want latest updated images and also with real time effect. But sizes are high for this kind of images. For a small reference works, Google Earth images are good.